This is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net, and today I am armed and dangerous. I am attacking my squash. This is after 2 days of rain. They have totally gone crazy. I mean, they are climbing up the trees. Now, what I'm going to do is try to trim off some of the ends so that they stop spreading and put more energy into making blossoms and some squash. Maybe I'll find some squash in here. Who knows? I'm trying to find an end. Here's one. And you can kind of tell the ends because they have these octopus vines trying to get off. I don't want to cut here because that will be a squash, so I'll cut right before it. And I don't want to throw the cuttings back in here because it'll just encourage squash borers to go in here. Do I even see any squash in here? I see lots of blossoms. Whew, and lots of mosquitoes. Now there is a squash forming right there. I think it's a green and yellow Russian squash. I think those are Russian squashes. Yes, and this, believe it or not, is just three plants. You can see one plant has the lobed leaves that are kind of a darker green. Then you have these that are a rather lighter green with three main parts to them. And you can see how they're climbing up the tree. They're hiding my hops. I planted hops in there to climb the tree. I can't even see it. I planted morning glories. Can't see them. And then over here is another kind of squash. These have a little bit smaller leaves with very few lobes. Now I can't remember now which is which. I think the green and yellow stripe were in the middle. Then there's a butternut squash and also a spaghetti squash. Here's one right here. That looks like a spaghetti. Now there's the tag way down in there. Let me see if I can get to it without getting eaten alive. Oh no, this is the butternut over on this end. Good to know. Of course, you'd be able to tell once they started forming. Ooh, here's one right here. Wait in there. That looks like a spaghetti squash. And this is climbing up the elm tree we transplanted. Let me just take this whole thing here. You have to be roofless because you have to kind of be roofless because they're just taking over anything that was in here. I don't know how I can get over there. Well, I'll start right here where I am. That one. This one. This one. I'm going to work my way toward the tree. Climbing up our neighbor's tree. Let me get this weed. And look what is in here. A beautiful sized spaghetti squash. With hops growing on it. Now this is a perfect size. You can eat this right away. Tonight. Here, Mr. Cameraman. Now, look at these. the hops are growing around now. Let go. Something you may or may not know about squash is that not only do they have the tendrils to grab onto things, but wherever they touch the ground, they also form new roots. This is a root that's just starting to grow. So that would be in the ground. That then would anchor it and give more energy to the rest of the plant so they can go on and on and on. We've sacrificed this one. Unless you want to eat the flower. They make a good squash blossom soup. You can make soup out of these. I'm sure there's a recipe on the internet. Oh, let me go out to the other garden now and get some more. Now at first glance, this just looks like healthy tomato plants growing. But when you look at it, you realize that the squash is coming through my tomato plants. This is a no-no. This cannot happen because those two end ones are my test tomatoes with my compost from the alpacas and the worm compost. So these squash are interfering. They will have to be sacrificed. Which is too bad. Because here is one. This is one of the green and yellow striped ones. I don't really know how big those need to get. This is the first time we've grown these. Now these are not actually sharing the ground with the tomatoes. They're not really hampering the growth of them, but they're entangling them and pretty soon they'll be shading them too much. They look kind of like cucumbers. They're not. Now I'll have to go on the other side to get the other part of that one. Oh, here's another one. And I'm not feeling bad about cutting them off because look at this. Same plant. So what I've learned from this is this particular kind of squash is too big to grow in a small space like this. And over there is my patty pan squash, which is fairly well contained. I need to start picking a few more of them and maybe trimming the bottom ones so the air can blow through them. And I also see that we have behind the cilantro, we have a bunch of red tomatoes. Now these have just turned red in the last day and a half. These were not here the day we were doing the strawberries. They were not red in any way. Okay, now that I have been chopping a little bit, I found my tag. I always leave my tags next to my plants so I can tell what they are. These are called Delacata Zeppelin Winter Squash. And they're from the 1894 era. Says the kids really love them. They're very sweet and they grow 9 inches long. So now I know I need to leave them on until they're just a little bit longer. These were not here 2 days ago. This is how fast squash grow when it rains. I mean, you can water them and they don't grow this fast, but if it rains, I now have zucchinis that are this big that 2 days ago were tiny. I gave away all the ones we had that were tiny. I now have big ones there. They grow quickly. This one says it grows 4 to 8 foot vines. Yes, it does, and even more. And they will, they'll last for 3 to 4 months, which is good, because zucchini you have to use right away. If these last 3 to 4 months before you need to eat them, that's a wonderful thing. Ooh, lovely bee. We love you, Bumble. Now, these are the patty pans. These have spikes on them, on the leaves. Now, they're not too bad. I mean, they will scrape up your arms. I always use gloves for squash and cucumbers because it's just easier. And what I'm doing now is just taking out some of the older leaves to give a little more circulation of the air. And if I can, I like to cut them off. Beautiful size. And I try to leave a little stem on them. Now, with these open stalks, it is an invitation to bugs, but that's one of the reasons that I have planted my marigolds. And I will pick off the old marigolds and just throw them, you can see where I've thrown them, right onto the plant, right near where the bugs would start. Okay, I know you're in here. This is one of the best sizes for patty pans. They are so tender and flavorful at this stage.